everybody. My name is Kat. I am one of the aviculturists here at Sylvan Heights. And today we're in our Avian Breeding Center, which is our behind the scenes area here. And today we're going to be going through something that we call egging. And this is something we do throughout the year. But now that it's the spring months coming, we are in April now, many of our birds are breeding. So today I'm going to show you how we prepare our nest sites for our birds, what we do when we encounter a nest, and how we go throughout the incubation process. It's going to be a lot of fun. All right, so I have in my hand here is what we call our egg baskets. It's a regular wicker basket, and the main material inside is actually down from many of our birds' nests that we come across. Now, the reason we use down is because it's naturally very soft and cushioning. Now, eggs, of course, are very fragile, and so if we have to bring any eggs into our incubator room, we have to find a safe place, a safe way to transport them and to keep them warm. Down is naturally an insulator, which is why the birds use it in their own nest. So we do the same thing in our basket. Now, if we need to check the eggs, check the health of the age of the eggs, we have our nice little LED flashlight here. Being LED is important because they produce no heat, so you're not putting on any accidental focused heat on the eggs themselves. And on a bright sunny day like today, it's very difficult for the flashlight to show anything. And so I have this special cloth here. It will mask, I put it over my head, look a little silly, but it helps to mask the sun away from me so I can see what's going on inside the eggs. All right, so we come across our first nest, and this one's actually a really cool one. So as you can see throughout the aviary, we have a lot of artificial boxes to provide our birds with really cool nesting sites, but sometimes I like to go all natural, so we of course provide them with a lot of space to do so. And even though right in front of me it doesn't look like there's anything that looks like a potential nest site, there is. There's a little ground nest here in the grass. I'm gonna see if I can move it out of the way so you can see it. And there's two little eggs in there. Now, those little eggs are from a bird found in Africa called the Hottentot. So I'm gonna leave this nest alone because she is not ready to incubate her eggs yet. Waterfowl will only incubate their eggs when they lay their entire clutch. And the way you can tell a waterfowl is getting ready to incubate is she will start plucking those down feathers from her chest area and line the nest with it. So I will leave her eggs alone. Once I start to see that down in there, that's when she will start to be incubating. And then that's when I will start to do the candling process. All right, so this is one of our types of boxes that we use here at the breeding center. Not all waterfowl like to lay their eggs in the grass or even on the ground. Many of them will actually like to lay their eggs in the trees. And so this is who this box is for. We call this design the porch box. And so when you lift up the lid and look inside, you can see how they like it so much. And they got a nice big cavity here, which resembles a tree hollow. And so the female will go inside this box and then lay her eggs and eventually start to incubate them. And this is a really special one. This is the hooded merganser egg. And so just like the other nest we found, she has only just begun laying her eggs. There's no sign of down in here, so that means she's still continuing to lay. So we're just gonna leave this nest alone as well. So we have found another natural nest site in the aviary. Nothing is in it yet, so this is what we call the scrape. And so this bird will come in and make a scrape ahead of time before they decide whether or not they lay their eggs. They do that to confirm whether or not they like the location. And I think this is a nice location. It's under a nice shady bush. There's some grass here to help protect it. And so they use their feet to make this nice little bowl in the sand. So we have come across an incubated nest in one of our porch boxes here. Now these eggs belong to a mandarin, which is sometimes referred to as like a Chinese wood duck. And so, like the wood ducks here in North America, that's why she has chosen this porch box. They are tree cavity nesters just like our North American wood ducks. So you can see she's got this nice layer of down in here. And as we said earlier, down is perfect as an insulating layer to keep those eggs warm. And it's also the perfect indicator that she is, in fact, incubating her entire clutch of eggs. So this is where our egg basket comes into play. So I got my flashlight here and my shade cloth. So typically what we do is when a duck is just starting to incubate is we let her incubate her eggs for at least 10 to 14 days. But we still need to check and make sure that the eggs are okay and that they're developing properly. And so I'm going to start looking silly in just a second, but I'm going to take my flashlight. I'm going to put this over my head because it is very bright and sunny right now. And hopefully that'll make it dark enough for me to see the age and the health of these eggs. So I have candled these eggs and I have determined that they are ready to come inside into our incubator room. So I'm going to put them in our nice little down covered basket here. So of course I have to do this very gently because these are very fragile eggs. But I take the entire nest with me. All right, so this is our incubator room. So those mandarin eggs we just got from the nest, they are already in one of these incubators. And we got different types of models, but regardless of the model, they all boil down to the same thing. They're all programmed for waterfowl eggs. And so all of our incubators are at 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit with 50% humidity. And that is the ideal incubation temperature and humidity for waterfowl eggs to develop properly. So those mandarin eggs just needed a couple more days to properly incubate before they are ready to hatch. So they are in this machine right here. Now when they are ready to hatch, we have these special machines called hatchers. And so when an egg is ready to hatch, they go into one of these, and the temperature is the same, about 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit, but the humidity is jacked up to about 85%. So it's pretty much a sauna in there. Now the reason it's that high is because in order to hatch properly, they need a lot of moisture so their egg membranes do not dry out, because that can make it very difficult for the egg to properly hatch. All right, so this is one of our hatchers. We actually have two in this room. So this is one of them, and there are eggs in here. So it's about 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit with about 85% humidity. And so as you can see, there are eggs in here with a crack on them that's called the pip. And then we even have some little guys that are much, much farther along. And it takes about 24 hours for an egg to completely hatch, at least it does for waterfowl. And so once they are done hatching out of their eggs, we will move them into what we call the dryer, or as some people like to refer to, the fluffer-upper. And that's where they would stay until they are ready to come out of the incubator room and start their life at Sylvan Heights. All right, well, guys, that kind of wraps it up for today. I hope you had fun egging with us, because I know I did. And I hope that gave you a really cool glimpse of a daily life here of an aviculturist at Sylvan Heights.